EPA is on the front lines for chemical accident prevention and enforcement. The risks of chemical accidents causing significant property damage and occasionally a loss of life are very real. We experienced the dangers firsthand in 2006 when Region 1 responded to a massive explosion caused by the overnight heating of highly flammable solvents used in ink and paint manufacturing in Danvers, Massachusetts. More than 90 homes were damaged or destroyed, and miraculously, there were no fatalities. That incident and other close calls redoubled our efforts to bring facilities into compliance with chemical safety rules found in Section 112R of the Clean Air Act. These rules require risk management plans for some facilities, while others must meet less specific safety requirements under the General Duty Clause. One major aspect of our work is compliance assistance. Highly toxic chemicals such as chlorine are used in some drinking water treatment facilities for disinfection. In one municipality, EPA's enforcement efforts resulted in the replacement of chlorine gas with a more stable chemical. This was a win-win for the city, plant employees, and people living near the plant, whose risk of chlorine exposure was greatly reduced. We also focused on plants that use anhydrous ammonia, a commonly used refrigerant that is extremely dangerous if not stored and used properly. Upon inspection, EPA has cited facilities for having ice covering critical safety valves, blocking stairways, and caking evaporator pipes that are full of ammonia gas. At a Vermont dairy, the lack of proper safety valves resulted in a major ammonia release where workers were splashed with an oil ammonia mixture, and the fire department couldn't immediately enter the facility because it lacked emergency shutoff switches and a proper ventilation system. In a South Boston fish processing plant, an ammonia release killed an employee. Chemical distribution plants also present unusual and perilous challenges. One facility was cited for storing incompatible chemicals next to each other, risking fire or toxic fumes, and for unsafe storage of hydrofluoric acid, a chemical so dangerous it can eat through skin and dissolve bones, and for having external corroded tanks and poor chemical management practices that turned this innocuous-looking rain puddle into hazardous waste. This plant stood out for its egregious disregard for chemical safety. It took Region 1 three inspections, three compliance orders, and a criminal plea to finally bring this facility into compliance. EPA Region 1's Chemical Accident Prevention Team expands its limited enforcement resources by working with local fire departments, state emergency planning agencies, OSHA, the Coast Guard, and the Department of Homeland Security. Federal, state, and local partners working together to safely manage hazardous chemicals. We also reach more facilities than we could possibly inspect by providing compliance assistance. Preventing chemical accidents can be very difficult and even dangerous, but it is crucial to protecting human health and the environment in New England.